Calculate the rate of flow of glycerin of density 1.25 times 10 to the power 3 through a conical section of a pipe with the radius on one end is 0.1, on the other end is 0.04. And the pressure drop across its length is 10 pascals or newton per square meter. So first of all, let's start with the Bernoulli's equation. We know that from the Bernoulli's equation, pressure 1 plus rho gh, that is height 1, plus half rho v1 squared. All this is equal to pressure 2 plus, again, rho gh2 plus half rho v2 squared. This is according to the Bernoulli's equation of fluids. Let's push the pressure to one side. So we can have P1 minus P2. Then we'll have rho gh1. So also want this to also come to the other side. That will be minus rho gh2. All this is equal to this velocity. That is half rho v2 squared minus half rho v1 squared. Okay. So P1 minus P2, this is just the change in pressure plus. Then here we can see that rho and g are common. So that is density times g multiplied by the change in height. This side, what is common is half rho, and we remain with v2 squared minus v1 squared. Okay. So make an assumption that the height does not change, so that the change in height here becomes a zero. So since the change in height here is a zero, what we're remaining with is just the change in pressure, which is the pressure drop. This is the pressure drop. So the pressure drop is 10 plus the zero that we get from here. We're assuming that the change in height is zero. On this other side, we'll say half multiplied by its density. Density is 1.25 times 10 to the power 3 multiplied by the difference of the two velocities. Like this. Okay, so this gives us 10 is equals to the value 625. Put them in brackets as v2 squared, v1 squared. Like that. Then we can divide both sides by 625, so that on this side we just have v2 minus v1, that is a squared. Dividing both sides by 625 will give us 0.016. Let's keep this as equation 1. Okay, so according to the equation of continuity, we know that area 1 multiplied by velocity 1 is equals to area 2 multiplied by velocity 2. Then, since we're looking at a conic section, the area of a conic section is in form of a circle, of course. So area is given by pi r squared, pi r1 squared, v1. Area 2 again is pi r2 squared, v2, like that. Then from there, pi can cancel out on both sides. This pi cancels out. If we divide both sides by v2, we'll get v1 over v2. We divide both sides by r1, we'll get r2 over r1. The radius, both of them, they are squared. So if that's the case, we're just going to replace. R2 is the radius 2 that we have, which is this one here. That is 0.04. Remember, it's a square. R1 is this value here, which is 0.1 squared, like that. So if we divide these two, the value that we get here will be 0.16. So now, in short, we're saying V1 over V2 is equals to 0.16 1.16, and if we cross multiply, means that so this implies that V1 is equals to 0.16 V2. This is our equation number two. So we have equation one, we have equation two. Let's combine the two equations. So to combine the two equations, we're going to substitute this equation into this equation. That is, equation one is V2 squared minus V1 squared. This is equation one. So where there's V1, let's substitute with this, because what we're looking for is V2 first. So we'll say V2 squared minus 0.16 V2 squared. Well, this is equal to 0.016, like that. So if we square this value, we subtract, we push to the other side and do the square root and everything, the value of V2 that we'll obtain will be 0.13 meters per second. So please go ahead, compute V2, because we just have V2 here. So we square this, we subtract them, divide both sides by that coefficient, then we square root them because V2 is squared. Then we'll get this as our velocity. So the rate flow of this glycerin is given by the formula. Rate flow is given by A multiplied by velocity. Now the A in this case that we're interested in is area 2 times velocity 2. Why? Because this is where, remember, on the where the liquid is coming in, that is V1, where it's leaving, that is V2. That's where we find the rate flow. So Q will be equal to the area, we said we're using pi r2 squared multiplied by the velocity 2. So Q in this case will be pi. The radius 2 is this value here, which is 0.04 squared times the velocity, which is 0.13. So the rate flow in this case will get the value 6.5 times 10 to the power minus 4 cubic meters per second. So there we have it. This is the rate of flow of this particular fluid. Thank you very much.